I loved Holiday Rush, you guys.
Thank you.
One of the things I loved most about it was that it wasn't just a romance between the two of you, but it was also just the importance of family, right? Biological family, found family.
Yes.
So with that in mind, did you guys have any family bonding moments on set with the kids, with Aunt Jo?
Oh, it's impossible not to.
Right?
It's impossible not to. Because there was, I'm going to just jump in here and be like this. Look, I was quite insecure when I first showed up on the set because I just didn't know how, if I was going to be funny without being racy and edgy as I normally am, but also not knowing how to set the right tone for the film and for the environment. And this young lady right here just showed up on some old powerhouse. We're going to do this. This is how it's going to get done. And it got done. But not only that, people could sense my, what's the right term? Trepidation. And so they were all being so incredibly supportive of helping me. And that just became kind of like this reciprocated energy throughout the set where there was a lot of people borrowing wisdom from one another, younger, older. And it also lent to your, you're kind of out in this bubble. And so it also lent to, the sense of family lent to your sanity. Because we ended up befriending the parents of the kids. And before you know it, we were legitimately sitting and eating together. So yeah, it's really nice.
Oh, wow. I love that.
It happened organically. It's like everyone made this decision, spoken or unspoken. It was, the decision was made. There was no ego. We came in knowing that we were going to be telling the story as a family. And so we would be a family in real life. Mm. And everybody was of the same mind. Yeah. And so we came together. It was very seamless.
Yeah.
I mean, and very easy.
Very easy.
You say.
It's nice to be in an environment where people are grateful about working. Sorry to cut you off.
Oh, no. I was literally just going to say, like, that explains why your friendship felt so lived in from the start.
Oh, you
know,
thank
just
you.
Such an important part of the film.
Yes.
Now, Sonequa, you have come from gracing my screen many a time in sci-fi and fantasy worlds.
Yes.
What was it like jumping into the leading lady of a rom-com?
Oh my gosh!
Of a real world.
Right! It was dope. It was so new for me. I really enjoyed it. It was very refreshing. It was like a breath of fresh air, that's not to say that sci-fi isn't a breath of fresh air, because it is in its own way. I really, really have such a passion for sci-fi and the stories that are able to be told and the prevailing themes that come through in the sci-fi genre. But being able to just be a woman, just this sort of boss woman from the city, it was like, oh, snap. You know, I'm not in these sort of heightened, like, you know, fantastic circumstances. It's really, I really just get to dig down into the sort of real world.
Oh, that's awesome.
And I loved it.
I also loved seeing you in it.
Thank you.
Now, Romany, you have a musical background.
A little bit.
Did that help inform the characterization of Rush in any way? Just someone who loves music so much?
Oh, without a doubt. I mean, just like we do these interviews, when you have a record out, you got a hit record, you got the number one rap record in the country, you kind of have to do a bunch of interviews like this with radio hosts. And you're sitting in the booth with them, and you develop this rapport with them, you hang out with them, you do club promotions with them, parties with them, and you start learning a little bit about their lifestyle and the way in which they have to navigate through their jobs, and like having the rug pulled out from under them, the constant this nomadic life that they live. And so no, without a doubt, I was able to tap into that, and also just having this appreciation, this universal appreciation for music, in which it was a career for me, certainly contributed to like understanding Rush's role. And then if we were to go a step further, you know, my dad raised me and my brother. He was a single dad who ended up meeting my stepmother. You know, he met his version of Roxy.
Oh, wow.
Absolutely. So
I love that.
Yeah, all of that.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, thank you guys
so
much.
And my dad was a DJ. Sorry.
You are. That's your life.
You know?
Yeah,
all right, now we know. Autobiography. Thank you so much.